5 years ago, he wasn't going to win any popularity contest inside of Busch Stadium.
No, the right fielder for the hated division rivals, the New York Mets, Darryl Strawberry, burst into the scene in the mid-80s as a power slugger. But life in the fast lane eventually derailed his promising career.
But now Darryl Strawberry has turned his life around, and instead of hearing jeers around town, it is cheers, because he lives in the St. Louis area, and he's here now to talk about what he's up to. Hello.
Welcome.
You can
Thank
understand
you
why Pleasure. We made such a mistake. It says D. Strawberry.
I can understand that.
And we knew you were coming, so
you can
it was
have
like...
That, by the way.
That's not me there. I'm here for a different reason.
Now, we know, and we know that you've recently put out a book called Finding My Way, how you've turned your life around. Obviously, you had a really tough time with drugs and rehab and leaving the game and coming back so many times. How are you doing today?
I am blessed today. You know, it's because of moving here to St. Louis. Been here almost 6 years, and you know, going to a church on the Rock. Pastor David Blount is my pastor, and you know, I came here and I just found that ministry, and I sat under that ministry, and my whole life has been transformed. You know, God has blessed me and my wife, and you know, you read my book, and I give the credit to God. I have nothing to do with it. I did my part of, you know, believing and seeking, and, you know, through Pastor Blount. It's just been a miracle is what happened in my life.
Did you have a relationship with God before all of this, or and then you just kind of fell off the wagon, so to speak, and then came back? Or?
Well, I think it's just like going to church. You know, everybody goes to church, you know. Do you really actually plant yourself into the Word of God and seek God, you know, and that's what I had to do. I had to seek God for myself and make a commitment to get a personal relationship. And when I committed to him, I got that personal relationship. That's when the transformation started, and that's when things started to go the right way.
And I'm curious to know what you think. Obviously, you were in your heyday back in the 80s, but now in this steroid era that they're calling baseball now, the return of Mark McGwire, the confessions of so many athletes, from John Daly to Tiger Woods to McGwire to the congressional hearings, what are your thoughts on all that? Should they all be given another chance, and should we put it behind us?
Yes, they should. Mark McGwire was a great baseball player, and all these guys that have personal issues, everybody's has a journey. Everybody's going to struggle with something. It's no hidden agendas in all our lives, you know. And it's just a matter of forgiving. You know, if God has forgiven us, why can't we as people? You know, and that's the most important thing people need to understand. Nobody's perfect. Mm. You know, I think sometimes we underestimate that and think, you know, we're perfect because you're athletes and you don't have struggles. You have issues from childhoods that you have to deal with, and sometimes they play out later on in your life. And unfortunately, you know, that's what happens to people, you know. And we just have to learn that we must move forward and try to turn the page. Mark McGwire could be a great example for young people, and I think he will. And, you know, I love Mark, you know, because I played against him in my career. And, you know, it was just his time of era where players got caught up in things. My time of era was different. It was amphetamines. It was drugs, you know. And it's always something looming around, you know, to try to make you feel better, you know, as a person.
I can see why you're a good public speaker. I mean, you...
Very engaging.
Whenever you get near somebody who's a good speaker, you forget where you are and what you... And you're going to be doing that tonight. People can lose themselves in Darryl Strawberry.
Well, not lose themselves in me. I mean, I'm just...
In your words.
Well, yeah, in my words. You know, it's a youth event tonight, 7 o'clock at Church on the Rock over in the youth ministry. And I'm going to be pouring into youth life. You know, me and my wife, you know, that's what we believe in. Mm-hmm. The next generation is the important generation.
Yeah.
Our time is passing.
Yeah.
You know, but this generation that is coming along, they need to know the truth. And I think, you know, most young people need to come out and hear what I have to say. You know, it's
cool.
Not about me. It's the
right.
Message of, you know, finding God and finding the right direction.
And talk that's about it. Irony. You were hated in St. Louis. Now you love it and you live here. That's so funny. And people like to see you too, right?
Yes. It's a great town. I had no idea St. Louis was so great, and I thank God, and I thank my pastor, you know, and the church I go to, Pastor Blount, because my life has been transformed through
Terrific.
His ministry.
Well, yeah. It's so nice to see you. We
it's
hope to visit
you.
With you again soon. Enjoy spring training. I mean golfing. I mean Mets spring training.
Yeah, you mean
we
golfing.
Know what you're doing.
It's golfing. He's going to spring training for the Mets, but thanks again for joining us. And we will put all the information that we had there with his appearance tonight at Church on the Rock on our website as well at fox2now.com.
All right.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
It's our pleasure. And the straw that stirs the morning show drink is Tim Ezell.
Yeah, Tim, what's on?